I want to talk about more advanced select statements. All right, so that's what I want to cover first of all, is more advanced select statements, including joins and including aggregate functions. All right, so that's item number one. Item number two is what I call the header detail model. That's where you have essentially a grid view or a details view and a grid view on the same page. So, for example, you might show a student information in a grid in a detail view. So you show the information about one student in a detail view, and then underneath it you show a list of all the classes that they're taking. Alright? So it's header and detail. The main information, and then a list of related information to the main one. Effectively, you know, for database fans out here, this is a way to represent like a one-to-many relationship. One student's enrolled in many classes. So we're going to show the student up there. We're going to show the list of classes underneath. Those are the two biggies that I want to do. And our next big topic after this is being able to insert, update, and delete on a database. And depending on the time, you know, we might get into this, or maybe this will be what we start off on next week. All right. So, what can anyone tell me about joins? What are joins in a database, first of all?
Is that when you're joining two different tables together?
Yeah, when you're linking two different tables together. And how do you typically link tables together?
Relationships.
Through their relationships, right. So there needs to be a way to tie table A to table B. And if you want to tie table A, let's say, to table C, all right, and there's no direct relationship between table A and table C, you might have to go through some intermediary tables, table A to table B to table C. So, in the example that we had last time, we were showing an employee and their department, but we were showing the employee and their department number. That will likely not be particularly useful. Right, because we probably don't know what the department numbers represent, you know. From the example last time, what was department two? I don't know. Finance, I think. All right. But again, someone's not necessarily going to know what those mean. So therefore, it'd be better to show the full description of the department. So we want to show the department name instead of the department ID. Alright, so that's what we're shooting for here. Alright, to be able to link it together. Now there's two ways that you can do this. Alright, the one way, which I'll bring up and we'll review what I talk about in CISS 143, the database class. The one way is you actually can use the where clause to do a join as well. Alright, normally we did something in a where clause like this. Select star from employee, let's say, where employee name like ZEL. And that would pick up everyone whose name included ZEL anywhere in their name. All right, so we went over an example of that. So the where clause can be used to filter data based on some criteria. And that criteria can be more complicated than that. Everyone whose name starts with ZEL that lives in Ohio and is a full-time employee. We can just tack conditions on with ands or ors. All right. Whose zip code is in this range, 440 whatever, all right? We can also use the where clause to join tables together. And we can use another way as well. The way that we join tables together with a where clause is like this. Let's imagine we have an employee table that has an employee ID, let's say, an employee name, and a department ID. And then we have a department table that has a department ID and a department name. Again, we wouldn't necessarily want to show the department ID because we might not know what that is. We'd want to show the department name instead. So we can't get the department name in the employee table, though, and we don't want to put it there, right? Because that would be not normalized. So we want to, since the way we link tables together are via the keys, we want to match up the department ID in this table with the department ID in this table. Think if you were doing this like on a sheet of paper. Forget about computers. Let's say you worked in the human resources office of a company, and you had a big sheet with all the employees and their department number, then you had another big sheet that had the department numbers and the name of the department. If someone asked you, what's the name of the department that Pete's in, you'd run down the list, find Pete's name in your employee list, look to see what their department number is, all right? Use that department number to scan through the department list and pull up the department name. Say, oh, Pete, yeah, Pete's in finance. Okay. So we're going to do the same thing here. And the way we can do that with the where clause is like this. First of all, we have to expand our from clause to include all the tables that are in play. All right? All the tables that we're going to use anywhere in our select statement have to be in the from clause. So, in this case, we'd say select from employee and department. Now, we have to match up the employee and the department. So, how do we match it up? We match it up by using the department ID in the employee table has to match the department ID in the department table. So we would say where employee department ID equals department ID. That's what you would do visually. Right? You take the department ID from the employee table and scan through the printout that had the departments and find the department that matches the department ID. Now, notice one thing. Wherever I refer to department ID in the where clause, I put the table name first. All right? The reason I put the table name first is because if I don't put the table name in front of it, SQL isn't going to know which department ID I'm talking about. What department ID do I mean? Think of, again, if we had a room full of people. All right? We don't have too many people today, unfortunately, so we don't have two people with the same name. But if I were to say, Susan, you know, can you come up to the board and draw the ERD? All right, everyone will know who I'm talking about because there's only one Susan in this room. There's only one Susan that's relevant at this moment in time. All right, let's say I were to go to a Browns game, all right, and have a megaphone and yell, Susan, you have just won $1 million. Well, there's probably going to be a bunch of Susans running down. Right. Might actually be some people pretending to be Susans too, but even assuming the legitimate ones, all right, even assuming if I really was checking IDs and all that, there'd be a bunch of people saying, where's my $1 million, right? So if there was more than one person named Susan in this room, let's say, if there was a bigger class or if I did it in a stadium or any place there was more than one Susan, I better fully qualify that name, all right? Maybe give the first name and last name. maybe give the first name and social security number, whatever. I have to fully qualify the name to say which specific Susan won $1 million. All right? Now, how is that relevant here? Well, the way that you fully qualify a database column name is by putting a table name in front of it. I want to compare the department ID with the department ID. Well, which department ID with which department ID? Well, the department ID in the employee table, so employee.department ID, compare it to the department ID in the department table. So that links them together. And now there's no ambiguity about like which department ID we want, right? We're matching this one with that one. So that is one way to do the join. And we'll start off and we'll do that. We'll create one from scratch, just for the heck of it, that joins the department ID, that shows for an employee the department. And we'll actually do that a couple different ways. All right? Now, here's a catch. I guess you'd call it a catch. It's not really a catch. It's just something that you need to be aware of. If there was an employee that had no department, then they won't show up. That join will fail. Alright? So, if we match up the department and in the employee table, the department in the department table, no employee, no department, it simply won't show up on the list. So, we'll play around with that and see what we can do about that. So, let's go and let's download the application from last time. And do some joins here. And if this computer is running slow, I might catch a quick nap first. Mm-hmm. Obviously, I'm yawning. I was yawning last night during class. I felt so bad. It's like, I really am excited about this material, folks. I'm just a little sleepy. I actually had two late nights. Monday I was up late for no good reason. I would attribute that to my body adjusting to daylight savings time and probably drinking too much caffeine. And I did catch a nap, which was probably what saved me from being a total zombie. And then Tuesday night I was up with the election results. So I got a fairly good night's sleep yesterday, but I think I'm still feeling the effects. Let's go and download. See, I had to say it, right? That would start to yawn. Pardon me?
Did you hear the one about the SQL statement?
No, I didn't.
So there's this SQL statement that walks into a bar.
Really?
Sees these two tables and says, hey, can I join you?
Oh my god, that is good. Did you just make that up, or did you hear it?
I heard it.
Okay, that's good.
I was waiting until you covered join.
You had that one back in your arsenal, huh? There's a lot of good science jokes. Well, there's a neutron that walked into a bar, right, in order to drink. And neutron goes, how much is that? Bartender goes, for you, no charge. Higgs boson particle goes into a church, and the church says, I'm sorry, but we don't allow Higgs boson particles in here. And Higgs boson particle says, I'm sorry, but you have to allow me in here. And the priest says, why? Why is that? Higgs boson particle says, because without me, you can't have any mass. I couldn't see anyone being offended by that. It's not, you know, I'm sure that the church would accept Higgs boson particles should they appear there and talk, so not really making fun of a religion.
I don't know, if it talks, they might be a bit freaked out.
Well, I think everyone would be. I think even seeing one for sure, I think would freak people out, right? I don't know if they've necessarily confirmed the spotting that we had, or that they had, that we had. Yeah, I was over there. Uh-oh. What am I doing? I'm telling jokes and I'm not paying attention to what I'm doing, is what I'm doing. Okay. I'll call this join. Oh my goodness, you missed unbridled hilarity a couple minutes ago.
Yeah.
You'll have to watch the video now.
Yeah. No repeats.
No repeats, right. All right, so let's go. And for this. So what we're going to do is we're going to do something very similar to the very first one we did. We're going to pull over the employee table, but we're going to join it to the department table. So I'm going to go and pull my data source over. I'm going to configure it to point to our connection. If you notice, every example that I've done, I have used the same connection. So if something changed, if the physical location of it changed, or the name of the database changed, or even if I changed the database provider, the database engine, to a SQL Server, ideally all I would need to do is go and change that connection string in the web config file, and I should be just, you know, in good shape. All right. Okay, I'm going to specify a custom statement, and I'm going to say select employee name, department name from employee department where employee department ID equals department ID. Think that's right? We'll go and test it. Yeah, sure enough, it works. I got all the names right. So I can go finish, put my grid view up here, style it if I want to. And bind it to my data source. I'm going to go in and edit the columns to give them more descriptive names. Do keep in mind, I've said this before, and I hate to be hypocritical, but sometimes in my examples I don't necessarily go in and dot all the I's and cross the T's and make it look finished, but You need to in your examples, all right, in your assignments and what you do. All right, so now we run this, and we get our listing. There we go. Now, things that could go wrong with this. Well, I won't demonstrate all of them, but there's one I definitely want to demonstrate. If, for example, I left out department ID, or I'm sorry, if I left out department in front of that, the SQL statement would get an error. One thing that you can do with any of these SQL statements, by the way, is if you don't get a descriptive of enough error, you can like copy and paste it in the access, and it will show you what the error is. It might show you what the error is in more detail. I'm definitely going to do this, though. I'm going to get rid of the where clause, because this is a classic mistake that people see, and you know, I invariably in any of the classes that do database, I get this question several times because it's a real easy one. It's a classic kind of error, and it is one that once you recognize it, you know, anytime it happens, you'll know it, and you'll be able to fix it easily. So I forgot the where clause. So let's go and run this. And notice what happens. Mike, Joe, Mary, and Sue are busy folks, right? Because they work in all three departments. That's known in database terms as a cross product. In other words, every employee is matched with every department. Remember, the sort of default behavior of these select statements is to include everything, right? If we don't put a where clause on and we select employees, it'll show us every employee. If we want to filter out employee by name or state or whatever, we have to put a where clause in to do that. It's very similar with joining. If we say that we have these two tables together and we don't specify how to match up the stuff in one with the stuff of the other, then it'll say, okay, I guess they want to match everything in one with everything in the other. So, if you ever run a SQL statement and you get a lot more rows than you'd expect, all right, you probably missed the join somewhere. Now, in this case, it was obvious. I got rid of the join altogether, right? I got rid of the where clause altogether. But sometimes what might happen, probably a more likely thing, is maybe you're joining three tables together, A, B, and C, and you join A to B, but forget to join B to C, in which case, A to B will combine properly, but the combination of A to B will match up with everything in C. So the key sign is when you see multiple occurrences of the same data that you know isn't right. You know that you don't have that duplicate data. And if you have that symptom, then look at your joins. Your joins are not correct. All right?
Can you show the SQL statement again?
Yeah. It was just a basic select without a where clause on it. So I just have select emp name, department name, from employee department. So I don't specify how to join the one with the other, and therefore it joins everything with everything. And usually, if you look, you know, you'll see, you know, if you're expecting 10 rows, you'll get some multiple of 10, right? Because it matched those 10 rows up with however many rows are in the second table. Let me go and fix this. not employee ID. That's a fairly common mistake, too. You match department, you know, you think, well, I want to take the department's department ID and match it up with the employee's employee ID. No, that's not how you link it. It's not that employee 1 is in department 1, employee 2 is in department 2. The department ID in the employee table tells you what department a person's in. So we should be back in business now. Now, let's go in the database and add an employee without a department. So I'll go into the database and I'll add someone in that has no department. So let's put in Pete. So Pete's in there. Now wait a minute, you might ask. I thought we made that a foreign key. How can I enter in Pete with no department number? Doesn't that violate the foreign key? Not necessarily. That's not what a foreign key really is. In addition to whether something's a foreign key or not, there's also whether it is a required field or not. If it is a required field, then yeah, you have to enter a department in. If it is not required and is a foreign key, then if you put something in, it has to be in the department table. But you don't have to put something in. So if you want it so that they have to pick a department for this employee, you know, no matter what, an employee gets assigned a department as soon as they start working for us. If that's the case, then you need to make it a required field. Then they would have to put something in, and it would have to be a valid ID. If, however, it might be the case that says, well, you know, employees, sometimes we're not really sure what we're going to do with these employees. We'll hire them in, and then we'll decide later what department we're going to put them in. Then you would make it not required, and you could enter an employee without a department, but if you did supply a department ID, it has to be in the department table. Now, let's look. And run this. We do not see Pete. Why don't we see Pete? Because we can't match up the department with department ID. This kind of join is called an inner join. And with an inner join, there has to be something on both ends of the join for it to work. In this case, there's not something for Pete's department. There's no department for Pete, so therefore Pete doesn't show up. We can make Pete show up simply by going into the department table, I'm sorry, simply by going into the employee table and giving Pete a department. So we'll go into the employee table and we'll say that Pete is in department 3. Let's try to sneak in department 66. Oop, not allowed, because 66 is not in the department table. But I can put them in department 3, because department 3 is in the department table. Now when I go and run this, I guess I didn't have to stop debugging. I could have just gone in and hit refresh. Now we see Pete, because Pete has a department, so the join succeeds. Couple of neat things that you can do with grid views. All right. It's kind of miscellaneous loose ends that I didn't think of, but might as well go over, just take a couple minutes. I can, on a grid view, enable sort.